Hi Gemini, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your mid-month love and romance reading for mid-August through mid-September 2016. I'm going to be drawing one card from the Angel Tarot, looking at the general energies for you during this time period, three cards from the Romance Angels Oracle deck, and one card from the Tarot of Sexual Magic, looking at the area of sexual intimacy. I have already shuffled all the decks, so I'm going to go ahead and draw the cards, Gemini, and get started with your reading. Again, this is for mid-August through mid-September 2016, love and romance. And again, you've heard me say this before, but these energies will be around before this reading, and they will linger on beyond this reading as well, so they don't stop, you know, necessarily right in mid-September. Gemini, love and romance, 2016, mid-August, September. Gemini. What are the messages for Gemini? Sorry, Gemini. Sometimes it takes a little longer to get the card. Ego. Oh, I'm gonna get some more cards on this. Ace of Fire. Release. Unity. Wow. Gemini. You've got a lot going on here. Three major arcana cards. Alright, let me get the Romance Angel Oracle deck cards drawn as well. I feel like the Ego card came up for you last month. Maybe it wasn't the love reading, maybe it was the life purpose reading. So it's a wonderful opportunity energetically for you during this year so far for you to begin to address some issues involving ego. Okay. The trust card popped right out of the deck. Oh, I feel like it's meant to go there. Okay. Getting to know each other, wedding, this could be the one. Okay. Let me get one more card. I'm actually going to wait on that one. Okay, so I'm going to show you what I see, Gemini. All right, so the Ego card just popped right out of the deck there. The text of the card says, a false sense of entrapment, being overly focused on material things, negative or fear-based thoughts. In the traditional tarot, it is the Devil card. Then we have, clarifying the Ego card, we have the Ace of Fire. I'll show you how I see it. We have the Ace of Fire, we have the Release card, and we have the Unity card. Very powerful energies. Ooh, I just got a head rush for you during this time period, Gemini. And then the Trust card wanted to go right here. So as I see it, it's really, really interesting. This is kind of how I see it, kind of stair-stepping like this, which is really fascinating because we have the Ego on one side and the Trust and Faith card on the other end for you, Gemini. Fascinating spread. And then here we have, I'll show you how I see it, we have the getting to know each other, the wedding card, and this could be the one right in the center. Whew. All right, so let me go ahead, and I am going to get one more from the Tarot of Sexual Magic in the area of physical intimacy for you, Gemini. And we have the Queen of Pentacles. Okay. Wow. All right. Let me just take in these energies for you, Gemini. Well, you are really being encouraged in the area of love and romance to create some major changes. We have the ego card, right? So the ego card is all about all of those things that keep us trapped on the material plane, right? This idea of addictions, overly focused on the material things, the material plane, physical things, sex, drugs, alcohol, those kinds of addictions and power plays. We have the idea of fear and anxiety running rampant, just taking hold of your life and all of your actions and thoughts sort of geared towards fear and anxiety, and this idea that you're trapped, you know, that you don't have the ability to free yourself from it. And really and truly, you do. You always have the ability. It's just that during this time period in particular, you're really being asked and guided to focus on these issues for your greatest and highest good. We have the Ace of Fire, which is a beautiful, beautiful energy for you, and it clarifies this ego card. So this ego card shows that you were, this is clarifying this ego card. And so the Ace of Fire is that with this focus on this ego, these are energies. It could be, I wouldn't say it's an actual individual, but it's an energy that's permeating, especially during this time period for you, Gemini, your life, and in particular, your love life, right? This idea of your ego. What does it mean? Ego can be ways in which we put on a persona. We're not being true to who we really are. We want people to see us in a certain way. Ego being that playing with those energies of addiction, gambling, doesn't have to be that dramatic. It can also just be ego in that you are not being true to yourself, not allowing your more spiritual self to come forth, and thinking codependency, right? You're putting your sense of power in the external world to give you the peace and serenity that you feel. So you are being, because this is a pattern, you are being asked to address this pattern during this time period. Right, so it's going to be different for everybody. It's a general reading. For some of you, it's going to be on one end of the spectrum. For others, it'll be, you know, on the other. But don't worry, because you're being asked to focus on this issue right now for your greatest and highest good, so you can grow and learn and expand and shift the pattern. Right, and this is the beginning of shifting the pattern. We have beautiful energy for you, the Ace of Fire. A new beginning, a new opportunity to take charge of your life, to change your life now. The text of this card says an exciting new opportunity, Gemini. Career advancement, change your life now. It's a beautiful call to action for you, and it has all the potential to be something really creative and something that you can really feel passionate about. And then we have the Release card, which in conjunction with the Ego card really does show that you are in the middle of a major life change here, especially in the area of love and intimacy. This is, in the traditional tarot, is the Death card, in that you are transforming, right? And when something changes, it transforms into something new, right? So you are in the middle of shifting this egoic pattern, Gemini. You have all this new energy and focus and opportunity and passion and drive to change your life. And with that change comes transformation. With that drive to shift the pattern comes this beautiful card, the Release card of transformation. Archangel Azrael, it says, the end of a phase or situation, spiritual transformation, time to move on. You are making some big changes here, Gemini, so I applaud you. It's not always easy. And then we have the Unity card. Again, another major arcana card clarifying this ego card. It really does seem that you are trying to... this is a card that can indicate the group very strongly. So it may be that you are shifting groups. You are becoming moved into an area where you feel more in alignment with your spiritual beliefs within the group. It can also indicate marriage. And with the wedding card here, it can also... be playing into that. Could be releasing a marriage because it's right next to this a Release card. And because we have the wedding card here, I think for some of you it can indicate that a marriage in transformation, a marriage ending, and your ego is all stirred up because of that. It doesn't have to be an actual physical marriage, but because we have the wedding card beneath, I kind of feel like it could be for some of you. For some of you, again, it is just changing your life completely, being called, being passionately called and creatively called towards something that's going to transform your life for your best and highest good. And also it'll be shifting your life so that you are beginning to connect with more spiritually minded people who have a similar mindset. The text of the card says, traditional viewpoints or methods, spiritual organizations, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. It is a card of change. It is a card of beginning to understand your spirituality more. It also can be a card of marriage. And then this card popped out of the deck, the trust card, right? And that the way it was laid out, it really is pointing at this entire spread from the ego to the unity here. And it's just saying to you, Gemini, this situation is calling for you to have faith. Like, trust that everything is happening for a reason. Trust in your abilities. Trust in your guides and angels to guide you through this. And know that you are deeply loved and always safe and secure. And the ego will try to come in and make you feel like that your peace and serenity and your safety is always in the external world. But it's always found within. It's always revealed from within, Gemini. So, again, this is a general reading. This is going to run the spectrum from, you know, extreme to less extreme types of energy. But again, it's a pattern in your life, and you are working to transform it during this time period, especially with that release card. And the more that you can do so consciously, the less painful it will be, because you won't feel so disempowered by it. And the ego card really is about a feeling disempowered. Because again, you're thinking that you have to rely on something in the external world to make you excited, to make you happy, to make you feel safe, secure, that kind of thing. A lot of messages there for you, Gemini. You may want to listen to this recording several times and at different times, because you're going to get the messages at different times that you're meant to. Okay, so then we have in the love and romance spread, oh, this reading is going long already. We have the getting to, okay, that's right here, I see it. We have the getting to know each other card. We have the wedding card right in the center, and we have this could be the one card. And as I look at these energies for you in conjunction with the spread up top and with the Queen of Pentacles at the bottom, there is a strong encouragement, let me say, for you to begin to really be real with another, whether you're single or you're coupled. The getting to know each other card, even though the text of the card says, as you reveal your innermost selves to each other, the bond deepens. Yes, indeed, that is true. But there's also another message here for you based on that ego card, that the more real and true you are, the more that you will be able to actually manifest what you desire, because with that ego card, that has to do with personas as well, and this idea of the false self. And even though the deception card didn't come up here, I'm really feeling like it's also really asking you, Gemini, to listen to someone else with an eye of critical thinking. Like, don't just take in what they say as truth. It's asking you to be a bit skeptical. So this goes back to this idea of sex with the ego card. Like, you may have a real attraction to somebody, and just, you know, it's asking you to be it's all about discernment for you right now, Gemini, right? Being more discerning in the way that you connect with another, so that the physical attraction may be there, but are you attracted mind, body, spirit? You know, it's kind of asking you for more discernment during this time period, as that ego card is kind of, the energy of that is kind of permeating this reading, and of course your life, especially your love life right now, Gemini. And then we have the wedding card right in the center. The situation involves marriage. Again, I spoke to it up here because we have the release card next to the unity card. It could be that there is a wedding or a marriage that is transforming, ending. It could be that there is a wedding that's about to occur, and that you are really being encouraged to get on the same page with each other here, get to know each other very, very well before you actually tie the knot. doesn't necessarily have to be a wedding either. Well, for some of you, it could be that you get to know someone at a wedding, and this person is someone with whom you may have met before. Okay, so we have this could be the one card. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. And so regardless of whether you're married or single, there may be somebody that is already in your circle somehow connected to you, with whom you have a very strong potential for a romantic bond, for a sexual union. And for some of you who are already engaged to be married, it's going to be different for everybody. It's a general reading. It could just be that, yes, this person that you're going to be married to is indeed the one, you know. It's going to be different. So, but with that ego card up here and all these major arcana cards, the release and the unity, I really feel like you are in the middle of shifting a powerful, powerful pattern in your life where you are giving over your power to something in the external world here. And really, you're beginning to understand that those thoughts that you think are real are really just an illusion in terms of when you give in to fear and anxiety. You're being asked to really, with that trust card, to have faith in God, have faith in yourself as a divine spark of you know, the all that is. And with that unity card, again, the spiritually minded community, there's a strong kind of clashing of, even though the Tower card hasn't come up here, there is a strong energetic force for you to transform this pattern. With that Ace of Fire energy right there, clarifying the ego next to the Release card and the Unity card, Gemini, you have a lot of patterns that you are working to shift, and there's so much support for you right here with this Ace of Fire right here. It's all the potential of the suit of fire at your disposal right now, coming forth, bubbling up to help you create and manifest the love that you really desire. It's very, very wonderful energy for you. And then with the Queen of Pentacles, we do have kind of this idea of that we have this woman here, and her lover is at her feet, basically at her beck and call, and she's, you know, really unavailable emotionally for him. She's really not that interested, frankly, in getting to know him. And that's why I think here we have this, you know, getting to know each other card. You can fantasize about somebody, but until you actually get to know them, you're never gonna have the love that you desire, because you have to really be open and vulnerable. And she's not giving an inch. She's not vulnerable to anybody. She's very much in a position of power. She's basically gonna step on him, and he's her plaything, so to speak. And it, you know, it could be male or female, it doesn't really matter. It's more the energy of the card. And she's kind of, you know, not interested in an emotional connection. Even outside, it's very frozen sort of landscape. And so this for you right now, Gemini, it kind of goes with that ego card. Like, let, you know, allow the vulnerable you to be exposed, to come forth, so that you can be emotionally available for the physical intimacy as well. That's going to be important for you. It's... you know, you are an air sign. You like to play in the world of ideas, but you're going to have to ground it if you want it to manifest in the manner that you would like. And you're going to, in order to do so, Gemini, you've got to face your fears, face you know, negative or fear-based thoughts. You know, it's you always have a choice, Gemini, and you know, if you don't feel ready. Sometimes, you know, you just take a little longer with it, but these energies are very, very present for you, so you're going to feel them in some way. There'll be some aspect of this that is going to show up in your love life, and again, it's going to be different for everybody. We're talking about a full spectrum here, so for some of you, it'll be more more minor, and for some of you, you're going to feel it. For some of you, it could be that you have an addiction, and for some of you, it could just be that you maybe are a little bit afraid to be vulnerable. So it's... regardless of how it shows up energetically for you based on your particular circumstances and your particular unique self, you do have all these energies of the Ace of Fire and the Release and the Unity card and the Trust card, so it doesn't really matter the specifics of it necessarily. It's more important for you to recognize the pattern and what it means for you and your specific life. So let me get one more card for you, and then I'm going to close out your reading, Gemini, because it has gone long. This is from the flower therapy cards by Doreen Virtue and Robert Reeves. Let me just see what the messages are for you here. Gemini. August or mid-September. So, Gemini, again, you might want to listen to this recording a few different times because there's a lot of different messages in there for you. And I don't want you to be scared. The ego card and the release card, it's not, doesn't have to be scary, especially if you can go back to this trust card. This is just as important as the ego card. It's a very powerful message for you. This situation is calling for you to have faith, Gemini, and that is just as important as that ego card. You're the one that gives these cards meaning, you know, by the way that you resonate with them. So the ones that you kind of choose to focus in on will have more power in your life. All right, so we have the laughter card. It looks like the wattle plant. Uplift yourself and those around you through loving laughter. So it's a beautiful message, and it is kind of an antidote to fear and anxiety, which goes along with that ego card. Laughter is such a healing balm, especially when we are feeling anxious. So spend some time doing things that make you feel joyful, even if you are in a situation that feels like you're more trapped. Spend some time with friends, watch shows, or do whatever it is that makes you chuckle and have a laugh. And it is actually proven that laughter does create endorphins and can make you feel better. So, you know, remember that life is not just about struggle. There's a lot of joy to be found here. And if you can do that during this time period in particular, it will help you get through it. And that, along with your trust and your faith, not only in yourself, but in the divine and in your guidance system to help you during this time period. Okay, Gemini, I hope you found that helpful. I wish you much love and laughter. And I will see you on the next video or at your private reading. Till then.